I got down to Orlando, Florida to take a small die-in congregation of 28 white members. And I got there with the conviction that I can transform that congregation into a multicultural enterprise. That was the core of my belief. However, I got there to find, and once I got there, I found out that the congregation was not prepared for somebody of another ethnic personage to become the pastor. And so over the, it's 18 months now, and 18 of them, of the original 28, have left, and 10 have stayed, and God bless those 10. They have really become a part of this new entity. However, I want to make sure that I say to people that I don't believe the persons who have left because of a heart sickness. It's not a heart thing. I think it's a matter of the head. I think it's an educative process. Had I the opportunity, I probably, to do it all over again, I probably would have had some classes on cultural intelligence to prepare those people for what was beginning to happen to them. So they left, but yet I believe that it's a head thing and not a heart thing. I thought I would document this in a book so that people will learn from my experience, will learn what can happen to them and how they can get a handle on circumstances that can happen to them. And I believe that I'm a strong advocate of cultural intelligence. And so this book is about how to be culturally aware, how to be able to work within a different culture and make a difference. So that's what the original title of this book, of course, the title of the book is Culture Trumps Religion Every Time. I had another title, and the title was going to be The Theology of White Flight. And I thought that was a little too explosive. Too openly explosive, so I've changed it. Culture trumps religion every time, and I think we get into a lot of trouble if we believe that religion is so strong, so entrenched sociologically in the person of individuals that if you leave it up to religion, people will come together. But there is the unseen hand. There is that elephant in the room. Culture that we must take into consideration. So that's why I wrote the book, that culture will trump religion. We love the Lord. We could be all Nazarenes, but don't go to sleep thinking that culture is not important. Culture is so powerful that so I hope this book will really help people in this battle that we have and the tension that there is in terms of planting churches and continuing to maintain churches. Pastors can use the book because there is one word that I believe the future of church growth cannot escape, one word, and that word is demographics. Thomas Friedman wrote the book some years ago, The World is Flat. Well, the world is flat. And whenever we think about planting churches, we live in a flat world. We don't any longer have to go to Africa. We don't any longer have to go to South America. The world has come here. And if we are to talk about starting new churches, demographics must play a very critical role in how we plan churches. And I used to hear people talk about the fact that We ought to have multicultural churches. And I'm all for multicultural churches whenever those who are involved in it want to have a multicultural expression of who God is. But ethnic-specific churches are critical. And I think that McGovern was right, and I think Peter Wagner was right, that people like to accept a new religious creed or dogma without crossing linguistic, without crossing ethnic, without crossing national boundaries. And I think it's critically important. And that's what I hope pastors will understand. There is something else about the book. I think that the book is grounded in scripture. The book is grounded in biblical constructs, so that Abraham heard the call of God to come out. That's why he kept getting in trouble, because he heard the call of God saying, come out from among them. I'm calling you out to be a different culture, a separate culture. And if you obey me, if you obey me, I will make you to be a culture that will be the envy of the entire world. And this is who Abraham was. And the Jews have always, what is the Old Testament but a compendium of the Jewish culture and the strength of the culture and the preferential option of God to deal with the people, the Jewish people, even Jesus Christ. And there is one chapter that I have called Jesus Christ, the Cultural Icon. And that Jesus Christ was a cultural icon in the sense that he ministered to the Jews. Why else would he have 12 disciples or apostles who are all Jews? In other words, it was important. Now, later on, Paul, of course, felt the call of God to go to take this message onto the Gentiles. But the whole idea of salvation is a Jewish concept that God, if this is how God chooses to work, well, we have to say that culture is so important that when God had to bring salvation to the world, God decided the best way to effect salvation for the entire world is to work through one culture, and through that one culture, through the Jewish culture, salvation has come to the entire world.